show. Are you ready to have a good time tonight? Entertainment pleasure, we present to you our most mysterious and miraculous tale, a stunning example of
magic.
Woo!
And merriment.
Oh. You will witness acts of
lust.
Holy war.
Love.
And a climax. Ladies and gentlemen, a climax justly famous throughout the civilized world. Not now, later. Our tale today concerns the firstborn son of Charlemagne and is entitled
Pippin!
His life and times. But before we begin, let me assure you that what you are about to see today is the true life story of Pippin. You see, there have been many misconceptions about Pippin. One, that he was
a hunchback.
Or that he was
enormously tall.
Or that he was
a midget.
Or that he was
would not like to
speak. But I beg you, cast all previous misconceptions aside and accept what we enact for you today. The life of Pippin begins. Pippin, as a child, showed tremendous thirst for knowledge. Immersed in these pursuits, the years went by quickly. Charlemagne sent Pippin to the University of Padua.
And the teachers at the university granted him the special title of Scholar of the House.
Pippin replied to this offer in his own deeply moving words. He may be a little nervous. This is his first time playing this role.
Could I have some more light, please?
Well, he's not that nervous.
Thank you. Gentle tutors, respected members of the faculty, I'm very grateful for the knowledge that you have given me, but I'm afraid what I'm looking for can't be found in books. I'm not exactly sure what I'm going to do or where I'm going to go.
And Pippin made a promise.
I promise not to waste my life on commonplace, ordinary pursuits. See, I know there is something.
Fulfilling. Something completely fulfilling.
Yes, that's it. Something completely fulfilling. And I'm going to find you. Everything has its seat. Everything has its time. Show me your reason and I'll soon show your rhyme. Cats fit on the windowsill, children fit in the snow. So why do I feel I don't fit in anywhere I go? Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. Got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Every man has his daydreams, every man has his goal. People like the way dreams have of sticking to the soul. Thunderclouds have their lightning, nightingales have their song. Don't you see, I want my life to be something more than long. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my until I know I'll have it all. So don't ask where I'm going, just listen when I'm gone. And far away you'll hear me singing softly to the dawn. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find
Not bad for your first time. Not bad at all.
Good job.
Thanks. Thank you.
Journey to a spot. Exciting, mystic, and exotic. Journey through our anecdotic.
The first day I was home from Padua, I tried to get an audience with my father, but they told me he was too busy. The second day, I tried at dinner, but he was too drunk. The third day, he came to visit me.
Enter Charlemagne.
This part is to be played by an actor of enormous power!
A giant on the battlefield and in the bedroom.
Oh. Well, thank you so much.
Good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Welcome home, son. Well, how have things been going with you?
Very well, sir. Some of my tutors...
Good. I'm a great believer in education.
And yet you have become the most powerful man in the world without it.
The most powerful man in the world? Pippin, don't exaggerate. What about the Pope?
Well, I rank you ahead of the Pope, sir.
I happen to agree with you. But things in my day were simpler. The sword solved every problem. Tomorrow is for you.
But it's still today.
But for how long? Pippin, sunrise and sunset are similar, but not identical.
Enter Louis, Pippin's half-brother, and after Pippin, heir to the throne. Addicted to the physical, Louis loves weightlifting. Louis loves wrestling. But most of all, Louis loves Louis.
Ha, 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 ha!
Well done, brother.
Well done. That was magnificent. Did you know this arm slew 20 Frisians last year, and it's going to slay even more Visigoths? Right, father?
Why do I get nauseous when he calls me father?
Enter Fastrada, Pippin's stepmother. Devious, crafty, cunning, untrustworthy, but a warm and wonderful mother. Dedicated to gaining the throne for her darling son, Louis.
Louis, Louis, guess what mommy has for you? Surprise!
Oh, look at this. Thank you, Mother. Isn't it a beauty?
It really is beautiful.
Welcome home, Pippin, my darling.
Can you imagine how I'll shine in the sun?
Oh, darling, you look beautiful. Doesn't he, Charles? Oh, Pippin, stand up straight. Didn't they teach you posture at Padua?
I failed posture.
Notice how straight Louis stands.
Oh, yeah, he's a real straight stander. No question about that.
Look how I shine. Ha! Visigoths! Ha! 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 Hey! Ha!
We're so proud of Louis, aren't we, dear? Oh, before I forget, the royal treasurer has informed me that I've overdrawn my allowance account.
You're overdrawn again?
Oh, Now, my lord, don't be angry with me. You know how confused I get about money. After all, I'm just an ordinary housewife and mother, just like all you housewives and mothers out there.
You know, sometimes I wonder if the fornicating I'm getting is worth the fornicating I'm getting. Well, Pippin, now we can have our talk. How have things been going with you?
Well, not very well, sir. Father, there are a lot of...
Welcome home, son, welcome home. I'm so glad to hear there's nothing wrong. Welcome home, son, welcome home. You be staying long?
Well, that's what I wanted to talk to you about, Father. I was going to ask you.
Welcome home, son. Welcome home. Well, I've got to go. It's almost noon. Welcome home, son. Welcome home. We'll talk again soon.
But, Father!
The campaign, we're reaching a peak. Marksmen tested themselves against the butts. Swordsmen tested themselves against each other. The panoply of war was being assembled. The sights and sounds of glory were in the air.
Glory!
Glory's in the air! Glory's in the air! And what am I doing?
Nothing.
Your helmet, sir. Oh, I'm sorry. I thought you were a warrior.
No, wait! I'll keep it.
But you're not one of us.
I'm Prince Pippin.
Who?
Prince Pippin! And one day, I will be king!
One day, I'll be queen, okay?
I think I'm going to talk to my father.
The royal court of Charles the Great.
Charles the Great, emperor of the Holy Roman Empire.
And a giant in the bedroom.
O great leader, blessed by God, sent to us from heaven's...
Oh, protection. What is it?
Soldiers, cattle, and wheat, due to a famine.
Denied. Next.
But sire, my cattle are dying and my fields are barren.
Denied. Next.
But sire, that is unjust and tyrannical. I object.
Take that man away and hang him. Oh. Next.
O great leader, blessed by God, send to us.
Oh no, not all that bullshit again. Out, out, everybody out. Council is dismissed.
Wait, father.
Yes?
I know what I want to do now.
Good, good.
I want to be a soldier.
What?
Yes, I want to join you and your campaign against the Visigoths.
Denied.
But father, that's not fair. You're taking Louis.
Yes, well, your brother Louis is an ideal soldier. He is strong and stupid. You, on the other hand, are educated.
But father, I'm your oldest son, which means I'll be king one day. Fighting wars is an important part of being king, isn't it?
Fighting wars is the most important part of being king. I mean, after all, the Pope and I have dedicated ourselves to bringing Christianity to the entire world, even if we have to kill every non-believer to do it.
Well, that's what I'm talking about. You're dedicated to something, and well, I just want to be dedicated to something too. And whatever it is, I want to do it as well as I possibly could. Otherwise, my life won't have any meaning to it at all.
Aw. You want your life to have meaning, do you?
Yes, I do.
Well, that's very ambitious of you, Pippin.
Denied. Father, stop all this bullshit and take me with you!
Well, that's more like it. Very well. Grab yourself a decent sword and come along.
Yes! I'm a soldier.
Right.
Me. A warrior. Finally. A chance to use my sword. My arm. And maybe even my blood.
Thank you.
Gentlemen, be seated! Map! Well, gentlemen, it's been a long, hard march. This is where we are. And here. Tomorrow morning at sunrise, we go against the Visigoths!
Ha! Visigoths!
Pippin, sit down. Now, the most important factor in tomorrow's battle is the terrain. So, look at this map. Study it. Remember it.
Father, why can't we just go out there and slaughter them?
You spoke, Pippin?
Yes. Since we're braver and stronger and have God on our side, can't we just go out there and kill at will?
War is a science, Pippin.
Well, that takes half the fun out of it right there.
There's plenty of fun when you win. War is a science with rules to be applied, which good soldiers appreciate, recall and recapitulate before they go to decimate the other side. Now, gentlemen, here is the plan for tomorrow's skirmish. The army of the enemy is stationed on the hill, so we've got to draw them down here, and this is how we will. Our men in the ravine, that's the area in green, will move across the valley where they plainly can be seen. Then the enemy in blue will undoubtedly pursue, for that's what you depend upon an enemy to do. Then to guarantee their folly, we'll bring bowmen into play, who will fire just one volley and retire to point A. And gentlemen,
and then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Heart the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilation, we can hear a grateful nation cheers!
Yeah! Pippin, don't interrupt. I'm sorry, Father. I just got a little ahead of myself.
Now, where was I?
Ah, yes.
War is a science, a breeding ground for brains. For though I cannot write my name, the men whose pens have brought them fame write endless paragraphs explaining my campaigns. Now when the foe see our soldiers marching through the lee, they will mount to charge and meet us at the point I've labeled B. Then their bowmen on the hill, in the yellow on the map, would leave their post to join the rest and fall into our trap. Then we'll cut off reinforcements and retreat of any kind, bearing principles of enfilade and defilade in mind. And if all the ploys we pick to really work to bring to pass occur, we won't have just a victory, we'll have ourselves a massacre. And then, gentlemen, and then
the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Heart the blood is pounding in our ears. Jubilation, we can hear a grateful nation.
Cheers! I'm sorry, Father, it won't happen again.
Now, in conclusion, gentlemen.
Now, listen to me, Minners, I'll endeavor to explain what separates a charlatan from a Charlemagne. A rule confessed by generals, illustrious and various, though pompous as a Pompey or daring as a Darius. A simple rule that every great man learns by heart. It's smarter to be lucky than it's lucky to be smart. But if the fates feel frivolous and all our plans they smother, well, suppose this war does shrivel us, there'll always be another. And then, gentlemen, and then.
No, Pippin! No!
And then the men go marching out into the fray, conquering the enemy and carrying the day. Heart the blood is pounding.
Your attitude disturbing.
I'm sorry, Father. It's just all this talk of enfilade and defilade.
Pippin, listen. The Visigoth king across the valley is talking about enfilade and defilade, too. That's the way it's done. Now, I always like to spend the night before battle praying, and I would like my two sons to join me. O God, we who fight in your name and in the name of your Son ask for victory in combat tomorrow. Give us the strength to butcher the infidel, that the righteous may flourish upon the face of the earth. Amen.
Father, is the Visigoth's king praying for victory too?
Oh yes, King Alaric is one of the best prayers in the business. Lewis, Pippin, it's time.
You're going to be very proud of me, Father.
I will try not to disgrace you, sir.
Very well. Follow me.
Battles, barbarous and bloody.
Thank you.
yet, folks.
I killed about 25 of them myself, Father.
Yes, you and Pippin both did very well. Now, we rape and sack.
What?
Oh, yes, and sing. It's absolutely essential to victory. Eat, drink, rape. Give thanks to God for the victory he has granted us.
I'm sorry, Father. You're just going to have to get used to victory celebrations without me.
Pippin, this is embarrassing. A victory celebration and my own son not joining in?
I thought there'd be more plumes. Rivers belong where they can ramble. Eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the
pit. Well, I see the story of a sorrowful lad. He had everything he wanted, didn't want what he had. He had wealth and pelt and name and all of that noise. But he didn't have none of those simple joys. His life seemed purposeless and flat. Aren't you glad you don't feel like that? So here I am from all the deeds he's done. Here everything's just begun. Here I am from himself with his mighty pop to run. Out into the country where he played as a boy. He knew he had to find him some simple joy. He wanted some place warm and green. We all could use a change of scene. Summer evenings, so full of sound. Gaining a lover, gaining a pound. Simple joys have a simple voice. It says, take a look around. And wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea? A crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea. A noose on a root of a banyan tree. Than a man who never learns how to be free. Now till he's underground. Enter Bertha! Pippin's grandmother, warm, strong,
caring, still attractive.
Very attractive.
Exiled from court.
Due to a personality conflict with her daughter-in-law, Fastrada.
Now living in the country where she enjoys those.
Sweet summer evenings, sapphire skies. Feasting a belly, you're feasting your eyes. Simple joys have a simple voice. This time is living prize. And wouldn't you rather be a left-handed flea? A crab on a slab at the bottom of the sea. A newt on a root of a banyan tree. A fig on a twig in the Galilee. And a man who never learns how to be free. Not till the day, not till the day, not till the day, not till the day. He dies.
Bertha?
Damn.
Bertha!
Yeah, who's asking?
It's me, Pippin!
Pippin? Pippin? Pippin! Oh, Pippin, I can't believe it!
Oh.
Oh, it's so good to hold you! To hold you like I used to when you were a little boy! Remember that, Pippin?
Well, of course I remember, Grandma. That's why I came here.
Pippin, you look terrible. You need some fresh air. Some sun, some good food,
oh, yeah.
Some frolicking, some Hanky-panky, maybe?
I don't know what I need, Grandma.
Yeah, well, I know what I need, Pippin.
Oh, Grandma! You haven't changed a bit.
But you have, Pippin. Now, something is the matter. What have you been doing with yourself?
Well, I went to war, Grandma.
No wonder you look so terrible. Men and their wars. Sometimes I think men raise flags when they can't get anything else up.
Grandma! Sometimes you say shocking things.
Well, I try my best. What's wrong, Pippin?
Well, Grandma, my life is going by and I have to start doing something meaningful with my life, but I don't know what it is, so I feel empty and vacant.
Empty? And vacant? Now, Pippin, listen to me. You're going to hear something very wise. Don't take life so seriously. Just take things as they come along. Don't do too much planning, and don't do too much thinking. How's that for wisdom so far?
Well, frankly, Grandma, I thought it was a little dull.
Dull, huh? Maybe it'll sound a little better with music. Hit it! When you are as old as I, my dear, and I hope that you never are, you will woefully wonder why, my dear, through your cataracts and catarrh, you could squander away or sequester a drop of a precious year. For when your best days are yester, the rest are twice as dear. What good is a field on a fine summer night if you sit all alone with a weed? Or a succulent pear with each juicy bite you spit out your teeth with the seeds? Before it's too late, stop trying to wait. Fortune and fate, you're secure of. For if there's one thing to be sure of, mate, there's nothing to be sure of. Oh, there's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world you're given. Time to take time, for spring will turn to fall in just no time at all.
But Grandma, it's time that I'm worried about.
Oh, now you stand over here and I don't want to hear anything from you until I'm finished. I've still got three more courses. But you can join in with me if you wish. And that goes for all of you out there too. But just the choruses. The verses are all mine. I've never wondered if I was afraid when there was a challenge to take. And I never thought about how much I weighed when there was still one piece of cake.
Spring, summer, fall, in just no time.
from everybody. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, it's time to start living. Time to take a little from the world we're given. Time to take time for spring to turn to fall in just no time at all.
Stop! Thank you. Oh. I think I'm going to take this one all by myself, right, guys? 1, 2, 3, 4. There's time to keep living. Time to keep taking from the world you're giving. You are my time, so I'll throw off my shawl.
She is absolutely right. It's time for me to start living and stop worrying. Enjoy the simple things in life. The fresh air, the cool, clear water, the fresh fruit off the... Oh yes, and women.
Sex presented pastorally.
Of course, women.
My days are brighter than morning air. Evergreen pine and autumn blue. But all my days were twice as fair if I could share my days with you.
Excuse me.
My nights are warmer than fire cold, incense and stars and smoke bamboo. But nights were warm beyond compare if I could share my nights with you. To dance in my dreams, to shine when I are done. And oh, my dearest love, if you will take my love, then all my dreams are truly begun. And time leaves ribbons of memory to sweeten life when youth is through. But I would need no memories there if I could share my life with you. Thank you.
enough. Oh, thank you. Thank you. Oh.
Boy, when you really frolic, don't you? Well, how do you feel now?
Well, nothing's changed. I still feel empty and vacant. There has to be something worthwhile I can do with my life.
Hey, you just started. There are so many things you can try.
Like what?
Like this.
Peasants revolt, Kingsley bounding.
Hey, look at this.
Peasants protesting a rise in taxes were slaughtered yesterday by Charlemagne's men.
What? What? That can't be true. My father would never just slaughter people just for protesting. That can't be true.
Now, would the news print anything that wasn't true?
But my father can't just tell people what to think.
Why not? He's the king.
I don't care. People have the right to speak out freely.
There's no doubt about that.
Something has to be done about it.
You're absolutely right.
I'm starting to see what my father really is. He forces people to fight and die over land that doesn't even belong to them.
That's right.
I think it's time for a change.
It is time for a change.
We need to dedicate ourselves to create a better world for all people. Peace and justice must be restored to this great land. The tyrant must be overthrown. Terror and bloodshed must be ended. I'm a politician. Yeah. We need a leader with the wisdom and the courage to sweep out the old order and create a better world for all people. Down with Charles, up with me. Yeah. I like that guy.
A son speaking against his very own father that way? I'd rather be drawn and quartered than think I was in any way responsible for what happened next. Word had come to me that Pippin was holding secret meetings of a treasonous nature. In fear of my beloved husband's life, I brought Pippin's activities to his attention. Pippin is disloyal to you, my lord.
Every son is disloyal to his father at one time or another, my lady.
But Louis loves you, my lord.
Louis is an asshole, my lady.
Mama!
Despite this rejection, I took upon my tiny shoulders the task of effecting a rapprochement between two men for whom I felt deeply. Back in my younger days, if things were going wrong, I might sulk, I might pout. But now I've learned if I just pitch in and do what's right, things would always work out. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could light a little fire, we all would be a little closer to our heart's desire.
Mama, if Pippin kills father...
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
But if father discovers Pippin's plots and executes him...
You'll be next in line for the throne, darling.
Mama, no matter what happens, I'll move up.
Yes, darling. Lord knows we've seen enough. Troubles already we've had our fill of gray skies. So put down the vinegar and pick up the honey jar. You'll catch many more flies. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could think before we strike, we all would be a little closer to the world we'd like. My lord! Will you be praying next month at Arles?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, but my lord, you always feel so much better after your yearly prayer on the 15th.
Yes, I do, don't I?
I sought out Pippin. Your father loves you, Pippin.
Freedom and dignity for all men is more important than the love between one father and one son.
But still, your name will be on his lips when he prays at Arles next month.
alone.
He prays at Arles next month. Alone.
Alone and unguarded.
Alone and unguarded. What date?
The 15th.
What time?
When the cock crows. Oh, Pippin, I beg you to bring this estrangement to an end.
I intend to.
May I tell your father of this resolve?
No! No. Let it be a surprise.
A surprise? I just love surprises. Your intentions make me very happy, Pippin.
You've been a great help to me, Fastrada.
What sweeter words could a mother hear? I know the parables told in the holy book. I keep close on my shelf. God's wisdom teaches me when I help others, I'm really helping myself. And if we all could spread a little sunshine, all could lend a helping hand, we all would be a little closer.
Pray.
Goodbye, my lord. Oh dear! In the hustle and bustle of my lord's departure, I completely forgot to warn him. Oh my! What a busy day. Events move so swiftly, it's hard for a simple woman like me to keep up. But something tells me that one day, soon, I'll be able to say what every mother wants to say. My son, the king! Wives and mothers out there. To the promised land.
It's all right, Father. You may come in.
I'm sorry to disturb you. I know you like to pray alone.
You know who I am, Father?
Of course, my son.
You want something from me, perhaps? A favor, advancement?
No.
Then what?
I came to be with you for a moment. To touch you. To look into your eyes.
And what do you see?
Two eyes. A little cloudy with age. A sunset.
What else?
Terror and bloodshed, the death of thousands.
You see that in my eyes?
Do you deny it?
Deny it? I'm proud of it. I brought order out of chaos. If terror, blood, and death were necessary to bring that order, so be it.
Those are words from the past. Time has passed you by, my son.
And your time has come, my son.
Yes, Father.
It's so easy from where you stand to judge the things I've done. But when I marched, the dust of the road was in my nose. And when I fought, the blood of the enemy was in my eyes. I sank on the shores of Volga. I drowned 2 legions in the Vistula. Eagles, ospreys, even vultures have a better view. From the heights, all things are clear. But by God, I blew my breath across the continent and shaped an empire with it!
Bravo. That was beautiful, Charles.
Oh, you liked it?
I loved it. They all did.
Thank you so much.
So you think you can do better than I?
Yes, I do. I have to.
Well, if that's really what you believe, then there's only one thing you can do.
Thank you. I brought my own.
Then use it. Or go and leave me to my prayers.
And what do you pray for, Father?
Strength. And may God give you the same.
Why won't my hand stop shaking when all the earth is still? When ancient ghosts are waking, so many steps need taking, so many plans need making, I think I will. I think I will.
Your Majesty. King Pippin.
Set to glow and sweep this whole land through. Morning glow is long past due. Morning glow, fill the earth. Come and shine for all your at the birth of old faith looking new. Morning glow is long past due. Oh, morning glow, I'd like to help you. Long ago.
Emperor of the Holy Roman Empire is prepared to hear petitions.
Come ahead! You will all be dealt with fairly. My invitation extends to high and low alike.
Sire, I am a poor man.
You may stand. You may all stand.
Thank God! My knees were killing. Thank you, sire. I am a poor woman, and I own not 1 millimeter of land on which I have worked so hard all my life. Is that fair?
No, that's completely unfair. But I will do something about it. From now on, peasants shall own the land they cultivate. Woo!
King Pippin the Just! Well then, I abolish taxes! King Pippin, the generous!
You realize, sire, without taxes, you have no money to support an army.
Well, that's all right. I don't need an army. No more taxes, no more army! Yeah.
King Pippin, the peaceful!
Sire, it is my duty to inform you that the infidel Hun has attacked in the east. He has destroyed 3 villages, raped hundreds of women, tortured and murdered thousands of your royal subjects.
Can he do that?
He has, but he'll withdraw on one condition.
Well, that's very reasonable. I'm certainly willing to make a small concession. What's the condition?
He demands your reproductive organs on a pike staff.
Oh! Well then, in that case, we're just gonna have to go out and destroy the infidel.
But men, I have no more men to wage a campaign. I have no money for supplies. I have no army.
Oh, all right. Nobles!
Yes, sire?
You remember that decree I made a little while ago about land and taxes? That's off.
You mean you want me to pay taxes and raise an army?
That's right.
But, sire, without land, I have neither money nor power over the peasants.
Oh, peasants!
Yes, sire?
I hereby suspend land reform! That's right, give it back!
Up thine, sire!
Take that man away and hang him!
Oh, no, not again!
No! Wait, stop! Just let me think for a minute, please.
Darling, you're a born ruler. You're doing a wonderful job.
Yeah,
nothing
thanks.
Has changed since your father died. Now about my allowance account. You put the money in the bank, and then it's mine. The
denied!
Money.
Denied, denied, denied! Everyone get out of here! I want to pray!
Pray? You're the king. What on earth do you pray for?
Strength.
Is there anything else you'd like?
Yes, I'd like to give my father's job back.
You want it? You got it.
I'm sorry, father.
It's okay. Just don't let it happen again.
Well, damn it! Nothing's turning out the way I thought it would. I'm getting old, very old, and I still haven't done anything meaningful with my life.
Well then, maybe it's time.
Time?
For the finale. Oh. Pippin, where are you going? The finale!
I have to think.
Of course not now, you idiot. This is just going to take a little longer than we planned. You better get Catherine ready. We're going to need her. But don't you worry. We won't disappoint. We never disappoint. I promised you a climax justly famous throughout the civilized world, and you're going to get it.
So we're just going to take a little 5-minute break for you to sit down.
There you are. How's it going? Anything you need? Whatever you like.
A little peace and quiet, if you don't mind.
Look, Pippin, you may not be able to believe this, but things are going exactly according to plan.
They are?
Of course they are. And you know something? He wasn't too bad. But what he discovered was...
You gotta be dead to find out if you're any good.
Then he dedicated himself to the church. He sought God in the byways. He sought him in the highways. Until he finally cornered him in a great cathedral. But what he found out was...
The church isn't saving souls. It's investing in real estate.
Oh. Manny, when things get dank, we'll feel their grip. Go, we stay. Tranquil spirits high, pulses low.
But what I've left behind looks trifling. What's ahead looks black. Am I doomed to spend my life a lingering on? Just lingering on, lingering on. Oh, I'll never find it. Never, 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 never. Shit.
Easy, baby. You're on the rise. Enter, Catherine. Well, where the hell is she?
Sorry, I couldn't get my eyelash on.
That's okay. We'll just try it again. Enter Catherine, a lovely young widow with a large estate.
When I first saw Pippin, he was lying in the road like a discarded rag. I would have passed him by. Perhaps I should have passed him by, but there was something about the arch of his foot. Yes, it was the arch of his foot that caught my eye. And there he was. He didn't know where he was. And he looked so lost and exhausted, you'd almost swear he was dead. The man had obviously lost the will to live, so the first thing I had to do was get him interested in something. Something that would restore his faith in life. Something like me. Well, I'm sure there are many things you'd like to know about me, aren't there?
No, nothing at all.
Good. My name is Catherine. I'm a widow. I have a son. I own this estate. I'm your average, ordinary kind of woman. Competent and neat. Making life a treat. Others as nice. You meet often, I know. At least once or twice every lifetime or so. I'm your everyday. Interest you much at all right now, but things change. Things change. Still, I'll understand if I'm not your kind of woman. Anyone can make one terrible mistake, but I've no special glamour, no fate I can twirl, 'cause I'm just everyday, commonplace, come what may, average, ordinary, wonderful girl. God, what a challenge. I was determined to somehow pierce that dedicated apathy. Now, I've always found that no man, no matter what his condition, could resist the fun and energy of a growing boy. So I sent my son Theo to him.
Enter Theo, a lovable boy and his lovable duck.
Pippin, Pippin, I say hello to my duck.
How do you do?
Guess his name.
Augustus.
Wrong, his name's Otto. You're not very smart.
I'm smart enough to know that a duck belongs in a pond and not in my bed.
Bite me!
Obviously hopeless. I'd picked him up off the road. I can throw him back out again. Out he goes. I'll give him another chance. Pippin, you've been lying in this bed for 7 days now. What's the matter with you?
It's nothing you can possibly understand.
Well, try me. Give me a chance.
I have been searching and searching for something completely fulfilling. And I haven't even come close. I'm in complete, abject, absolute despair.
And that's it?
Yes, that's it.
You may think what I did next was a little underhanded. Pippin, let me tell you something about despair. I loved my husband very much. The years we spent together were the happiest years of my life. And then one day, he was struck with fever. And when his hand went cold in mine, I felt as if my life too was over. I was overcome by the deepest despair. I took to my bed for 5 days. On the sixth day, I got up. There were things to be done, an estate to be run, a boy to raise. But look at that. I think he's really moved. Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here, and I can't do all of this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
Hold it! Hold it. You're supposed to read that line naggingly.
But he touched my hand. They don't usually do that.
I don't care where he puts his hand. Read it naggingly.
Pippin, this is such a large estate. I'm all alone here, and I can't do all of this work by myself. Couldn't you please help me?
All right, all right. Anything to shut you up.
Well, Pippin was finally out of bed and working, and soon he became part of everything, part of our everyday lives. Every day.
Every day? Every day. That's exciting. Hey, did you say something?
No.
Oh, I know that look. That's the look of a widow with a large estate and no one to sit at the head of the table.
No enthusiasm at all.
Well, what are you looking at?
Nothing. Oh, Pippin, there is something. The roof on the chicken house has sprung a leak. If you could get to it tomorrow.
Wait a minute.
Or the day after tomorrow.
The roof on the chicken house! Patching the roof and pitching some hay. It's not my idea of a perfect day. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. I'm not the type who loses sleep over the size of the compost heap. When you're extraordinary, you gotta do extraordinary things. Oh, I once knew a man. He lived each day the same, safe and sane and swell. And when they told me he died, I didn't cry. All I could say was, how can they tell? Oh, looking at life from deep in a rut may give you a view of the sunshine, but it's so secondary for someone who is very extraordinary like me. If the floorboards are squeaking and the doorboards are leaking and the chimney's in need of repair, if the garden's in rambles and the yard is in shambles, well, I'm terribly sorry, but I don't care. I've gotta be someone who lives all of his life in superlatives. I'm extraordinary. I gotta do extraordinary things. The fact that I'm special is easy to see. So why doesn't anybody see it but me? I'm extraordinary. I gotta do extraordinary things. Every so often, a man has his day. He can truly call his. Well, here I am to seize the day. If someone will just tell me where the hell it is. Oh, give me my chance and give me my wings. And don't make me think about everyday things. They're so secondary for someone who is very extraordinary. I'm leaving. I'm getting out of here.
And then Theo's duck got sick.
Pippin! Otto got sick.
Oh, that's too bad, Theo. I'm sorry.
Pippin, it's the first time he's come to you for help.
Can you look at him? Please?
Please. Pippin.
Oh, Theo, I don't know anything about ducks.
Pippin. Try.
Oh, all right, I'll have a look at him. This is a very sick duck. There's nothing I can do for him. Oh, wait a minute, Theo. Yes, there is. Come on over here. Right over here. Kneel down right next to me.
It was like a painting. Men and boy at prayer.
God, I know this is going to sound ridiculous, but this boy loves this duck.
They prayed all day, and then, just after sunset, the duck died.
Oh, Theo, I'm sorry. Hey, why don't we just go out to the pond and get another duck? Why did the goddamn duck have to die?
And then, an interesting thing happened. Theo plunged himself into monumental despair, while on the other hand, Pippin, the Prince of Despair, dedicated himself to raising the boy's spirits.
Theo! Hey, Theo! We're going out to pit some hay and we need another good man. Why don't you come lend a helping hand? Another time, maybe.
But Pippin showed remarkable persistence. When one thing failed, he tried another.
Theo! Hey, Theo, guess what I got for you this time? One, two, three. Look!
It's not a duck, dumbass!
Did I say it was a duck? Oh, go on, you were a flop.
Well, most men would have given up, but Pippin, with amazing perseverance, tried yet another way.
Theo! Check this out.
Yeah!
Oh.
Listen, I think we're gonna skip this part. Nothing much happens. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. A whole lot of that. But the seasons changed as they always do. And every day was filled with those everyday things. Seeds to be sown, fences to be mended, and finally, a love song to be sung.
Sitting on the floor and talking till dawn.
Candles and confidences.
Tweeting old beliefs and humming old songs.
And lowering old defenses.
The love song. La 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 la. Love song. La 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 la. Private little jokes and silly. Cliches and all of the games.
And all of the strange emotions.
Singing a love song. La 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 la. Love song. La 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 la. They say the whole is greater than the sum of the parts it's made of. Well, if it's true of anything,
it's true of love.
So how can you define a look or a touch?
How can you weigh a feeling?
calls, and now they don't mean much.
Together they send you really to
a love song. La 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 la.
Why?
Because we have a surprise for you.
I usually don't like surprises.
Well, you'll like this one.
Can I open my eyes yet?
Yes, now you can. I haven't made it in years, but I thought for this special occasion.
What special occasion?
Well, a year ago today, you arrived here. So Theo and I thought that we would celebrate with a little party. So I made this, and Theo got you this.
Here.
Oh, Theo! It's beautiful. Come here. I don't know what to say.
Well, let me say something then. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flowed under the dam.
Over the dam. Water flows over the dam.
I'm sorry. I know. I seem to be a little confused.
I can see that. Try sticking to the part, huh?
I will. In the year that you've been with us, a lot of water has flowed over the dam. You've come to mean a great deal to me, to us, to our very ordinary lives. So I just wanted to say, for me, and for Theo, we're glad you're here. And now, well, now we have so many great years ahead of us. Sit here. Sit here, right at the head of the table. Well, isn't anybody going to eat this?
I am.
I've got to get out of here.
Pippin, what's the matter?
I just can't stay here.
I don't understand.
I have to go.
Why?
Because this isn't enough. Life is more than ducks that die and leaking roofs.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. And I'm not going to be stuck doing the same goddamn thing every day.
And night?
Don't you see? There has to be something more than this. There has to be.
Well, maybe there isn't any more.
I know there is. Rivers belong where they can
ramble. I loved my husband
ramble.
Very much. And the years we spent together were
Eagles
the happiest years of my life.
Where they can
and when...
fly.
What's my line? I can't remember my next line. Pippin? Pippin, please don't go! I love you, Pippin. I love you. Could you hold the light a minute, please? Thank you.
Pippin. I guess you finally realize what we knew from the beginning.
What's that?
That your search for meaning and fulfillment was doomed from the start.
That nothing ever turns out the way you think it's going to?
It's all flawed in one way or another.
Isn't that true?
Nothing has been completely fulfilling. Has it, Pippin? Has it? Has it?
No. I guess there's nothing.
Wait. Wait a minute. There is something.
There is?
Yes. Yes.
What is it?
The only completely perfect act in our repertoire. The finale!
The finale!
Now.
Now.
Woo!
Finale? But that was just a trick.
When he does it, it's just a trick. When you do it, it'll be for real.
When I do it. You mean you want me to? Oh, wait a minute.
You will step into that flame,
Pippin.
Become part of that flame.
Flame itself.
And for one moment, shine with unequaled brilliance.
You will become a glorious synthesis of life and death!
And life again.
Why, the final affirmation of life. Death! Ladies and gentlemen, presenting the great Pippin in our grand finale, justly famous throughout the civilized world.
Stop! Stop that! Look, if this finale is so spectacular, then why doesn't one of you do it?
Look, Pippin, we're just ordinary, run-of-the-mill people. Just your everyday men and women who keep this old world spinning. Hell, we're nothing. But you, Pippin, you are an extraordinary human being with extraordinary aspirations and dreams.
Deserve an extraordinary climax. An unparalleled.
It's everything you've been looking for.
Like the sun, blazing.
The sun at its zenith.
Look, it's just that, if this isn't it, I'm gonna have a hard time trying something else.
Pippin, you lack a certain amount of poise.
Think of the glory.
The feeling of power. Radiant, like the glow of morning. Think of the word of God.
About your name.
These are dim lights to share.
Think about the beauty in one perfect flame. When the angels of the morn are calling out your name.
No! Please don't do this to me! I'm not a river or a giant bird that soars to the sea. And if I'm never tied to anything, I'll never be free.
What the hell are you doing out here? Pippin, stop this nonsense and get on with the finale, Pippin, the finale!
I wanted magic shows and miracles, mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. It never was there. It always was here.
All right. You'll see what it's like without us. Take away the set, everything out, move it. Colored lights out, take them out, pinks and reds out. Well, that's not too flattering, is it, Pippin? Costumes, get their costumes. Makeup, let's go, get it off. Look around, Pippin. How do things look to you now?
They showed me crimson, gold, and lavender, a shining parade.
A mole. Pippin, look at the mole on her face. You're going to spend the rest of your life with a woman with a mole?
But there's no color I can have on earth that won't finally fade.
And the kid, do you know how much he's gonna cost you? He's gonna whine 24 hours a day. Oh, give me this, give me that.
When I wanted worlds to paint,
this is the way you want to live. Is this what you want?
And costumes to wear.
No costumes, no makeup.
Never was there.
No colored lights.
It always was here.
And no magic. Inability to bring you the finale that we promised. It seems that our extraordinary young man has elected to compromise his aspirations. But I know that there are many of you out there, extraordinary people, exceptional people, gladly trade your ordinary lives for the opportunity to do one perfect act. Our grand finale. If you should decide to do so, we'll be here for you. Waiting. Why? Promise you sets, costumes, lights, magic. And a short but spectacular career. Everybody out! Out! Take away the rest of the lights! Orchestra, pack up your instruments! Get out! Let's go! Take your damn hands off that keyboard! You try singing without music. Sweetheart.
I wanted magic shows and miracles. Mirages to touch. I wanted such a little thing from life. I wanted so much. I never came close, my love. We nearly came near. Never was there. It always was here.